right, it's a beautiful one, and of course yet another episode for The Flick right here on Living, ready to give you the latest of what is happening. This is one of the shows that makes you feel like you should be proud of the Ugandan film industry, because I do bring you the nitty-gritties behind all films as far as, you know, representing 256 is concerned. My name is yours truly, Derek Dasha, the Ugandan movie ambassador, and this evening I'll be talking to a young, talented man, you know, as we call them, the young blood. This guy, I had him on the show a couple of weeks ago when he was talking about his movie, which is actually a feature film, and he had a premiere that did go down. He's here to tell us some of his experiences, and it seems like, you know, work did actually pay off, because we get to find out that he was nominated in the UFF this year. What other way to actually congratulate someone other than having them here to share their experience? Katongole Najib. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good. How are you?
How is life treating you after that whole, you know, premiere up and down and having your movie being the way you wanted it to be?
Well, I'm so blessed. I'm so thankful. Thanks to God who enabled me to go down the road. I happened to get the nomination from the Uganda Film Festival 2018. In the category of best student film.
Now, before we get into the UFF, I want us to go step by step. Let us do a little bit of rewind to the day you premiered this movie. Your first time working on a project, I remember you telling me, Derek, I've been pushing this project on a one-man basis.
Yeah.
How was it? How was the turn-up like? Did you enjoy the people that did come to cast this movie?
First of all, I enjoyed it because people came in big numbers. Yeah.
I missed you so terribly.
I don't care about money, as long as I get what I want.
People came in big numbers, and they had a few remarks about the film. They were like, oh, if you really can do this at this young age, then you have, like, you have a big way to go. Like, you can see the future. Don't give up. Don't do what. Just keep on pushing hard, and just keep on working every day and every night. You're going to get there.
What are some of your biggest challenges that you remember? You hold them so dearly, because me, I believe with challenges, that's when you get to learn the most. Some of the challenges that you faced when trying to pull off this premiere.
Well, some of the challenges that I try to face, it's about financial bit. Yeah. So, you know, you have to put in all that you have in order to push your dream to come true. Understand, you have to sacrifice what it takes in order for your dream to be there, to come true.
Now that you've been nominated in the UFF, they will definitely come through. Talking about these nominations, I do have a small teaser for you regarding The Wrong Direction, a reason as to why you need to look for this movie, because it was nominated in the UFF this year. Check out the trailer and we'll be right back.
All yours, as long as you got some money.
So you want my body, right?
Baby, I missed you so terribly.
I don't care about money, as long as I get what I want.
I'm feeling uncomfortable when I see you no more.
I'm so blessed having her by my side.
Tell me, what's wrong?
I had it being broke like you.
Alright, look, I need you to do me a favor.
Oh my god, you're doubting me.
She's a... Stop talking about her like that.
No,
Michael, stop.
But all that you think of is partying, having good cars, and being on top of the world. Don't ever talk to me like that.
What's wrong with you, man?
Do you know that I'm trying to call this girl, but she's not picking up my calls.
I don't love him, and I've never loved him.
You either repeat the same stuff, or you do what I tell you to do.
What are you going to do?
Alright, now I hope you did enjoy the trailer. I managed to watch a full movie myself, so I had a good time. Now let's talk about the fact that you have been nominated under the category of Best Student Film in the Uganda Film Festival this year. How does that make you feel, personally? How do you feel about this?
First of all, I'm so happy. For real, I'm so happy. Like, when I was home, I got a call from the director, that is Mutebi Farouk. So he was like, oh, because I was there, I was even trying to do my own stuff. Mm-hmm. So
thinking
I got
about the next project.
Yeah, thinking about the next project, you have to shoot, you have to do this, you have to do that. Then I got a call from the director, and he was like, "Oh, Najib, how are you? I'm doing good. Did you check the list of the nominations 2018?
You are the people UFF? Who don't read newspapers, okay?
No, not that. Because I was about to go to the media and check it out. So he was like, did you see anything about the UFF? And I'm like, no. So he's like, I've seen the wrong direction. Mm. And I'm like, come on, you're joking. Because I know it's really not easy. Mm-hmm. It's really not easy. Making it in the UFF, it's really hard. But thank God, I don't know how I did that, but thank God. Of Desmond Washington, he said, don't give up. Life is going to suck for you one time. You're going to feel like a fool, but don't fall back.
Don't fall back, yes.
Fall forward.
Forward, an interesting way. Now, I guess you have another thing to actually look up to as we do get to wind up with this interview. I just have a reminder for you. Down here at Century Cinemax, we usually do it big. Now, Robin Hood is going to be coming out anytime this month. So come and be part of this interesting one. The legend you know, but the story you didn't know. We have all grown up in the times of Robin Hood. We've had a couple of movies, series talking about Robin Hood. But this time round, November 23rd has another one coming for you. So be ready. Come and book your tickets in advance and be part of this interesting experience. I'll see you guys on the timeline, or even on 23rd when I come to pick my ticket for Robin Hood. Peace out.